Greetings everyone, this is Real Estate Chat, where we discuss issues that have to do with the real estate industry, from land development, land acquisition, proper disposal, letting and subletting, real estate trends locally, regionally, internationally. So don't forget to subscribe on our channel, Real Estate Chat, so that we'll be able to be well advised with current precise information concerning the real estate industry. So today we are going to touch on our first episode on the buyer's guide, which is the value of lands. So the value is going to determine, is going to guide you all along. So it all starts with your budget. How much have you budgeted to buy the piece of land without considering developing it, without considering constructing anything on it, but just for the piece of land. So there must be a balance between what you prefer and what you can afford. So most of us, we prefer nice things, but the question is, do we really afford it? So sometimes you chew what you won't be able to swallow. Most of us, we become overzealous and buy something that we won't be able to construct. And at the same time, some of us, we buy something that we will overconstruct on a smaller piece of land. And at the same time, at the end of the day, you will be regretting every day staying in that house. So remember, buying land is different from buying shoes or buying a pair of trousers, because you can still buy another one, you can change it. But when you're buying a piece of land, something, it's a lifetime investment. It's where you're going to spend much of your time in. It's where you're going to expect your income to come from. So you need to be very, you need to take much of your time considering making your decision. You need to consider a lot of factors, especially blind spots, because most of us, we can be blinded. Remember, these real estate agents and developers, what they want is for you to buy. So they won't tell you all other blind spots of which you need to know. So whenever you are dealing with them, you'll be asking them to look for something that can meet your needs or your desires or what you expect or what you prefer, you and your family and you and your company, if it's for investment. So when we are at the value, let's assume you want to buy the piece of land that is going for $20,000. So it means the piece of land must retain the value that is equivalent to $20,000. So the first factor that you need to consider is the issue of location. Where is it located? Remember, location speaks a lot in terms of value. Remember, the same piece of land in Chitungi is a different values with the same piece of land in Mount Pleasant. And even in Borodom, the piece of land values consider where is it located. Is it closer to the Semile village? Is it far from the Semile village? So those factors, they can also bring differences. Is it closer to Headcliff? For example, the way Borodom or Ogatio, the value differs from the piece of land that is in Borodom, which is closer or next to Semile, just because of distance it has. And sometimes it might have the equal distance, but the question is, where is it located? Is it located next to what? So those factors, you also need to consider them, especially on location and the issues of development of the neighboring developments or neighboring locations or settlements. Are they developed much? Do we have high crime rate? Do we have a high rate of unemployment? All such questions, you also need to put them into consideration. And then while you're on location, you also need to consider topography. For example, you're purchasing something in Kroyo. It's a mountainous area and it's very expensive to construct it there. So that factor also need to bring it in. If you are buying something in wetland, because there's a need for special foundation, so you also need to factor it in before buying that piece of land. You also need to factor in, so you have to negotiate for the price to be lower or to change to go for something that won't be expensive when you want to construct it. You also need to consider the issue of availability of sewer system, sewer articulation system, water articulation system, electricity. Is that area well developed? Is it accessible? Do we have tight roads? Do we have dust roads? So all those factors, you also need to consider them. In terms of convenience, is it convenient? How far am I from neighboring shops? Do you have shops in that same area? Do you have those basic amenities in that same area? Do you have supermarkets? Do you have medical facilities? Do you have schools? How long does it take for me to drop my kids at school? How long does it take for me to drive to the supermarket? How long does it take for me to go to town? How long does it take for me to get closer to the next public transport? Is it accessible in terms of security? Is it secure? Do you have a high crime rate in a particular area? And then we go on to the issue of zoning. Remember, we have the zoning factors of we have the floor factor in terms of zoning. Some areas are restricted to one floor alone, so you won't be able to utilize on the same piece of land, because when other areas are the three factor flow. So if you are allowed to go three floors up and another area, you are only allowed one floor. So it means that one with the three factor flow, it means it must have a higher value as compared to that one with only one floor. And there's also, in terms of PP area, building lines, there are certain areas where you are restricted to build the percentage of coverage of your house in terms of the percentage coverage of your stem size. So you also need to consider those issues. And also another issue of mixed land use. There are areas whereby we have restricted land use. It's a strictly residential. You are not even allowed to put an office, maybe, unless if it's a family run business. Or in other areas, there's mixed land use. Let's say, for example, we have Belgravia, we have Alexandra Park, we have Milton Park, and we have Avanton. Those areas, they mix the land use. You are allowed to put it's a commercial, residential, even office space, and even as well as you are allowed even to put flats there. So it means the land has to be expensive. You need to expect a higher value as compared to those with the restricted land use. And you also need to consider issues of demand and supply factor. But do we really have high demand in that area? For example, let's take, for example, Senga, closer to MSU, Middle Eastern State University. In terms of setup, it's more or less equal to Mkoba. But Lady Senga is expensive. Why? Because there's a high demand for student accommodation. So you also need to consider those factors, because you never know. Maybe you think the house that you are buying, you want to stay there. But maybe in the future, you would want to have another house and use that for investment, use that for rental purposes, or you want to convert it into commercial, you want to convert it into a restaurant. So you also need to consider all other factors before making a commitment, before making up a decision in that particular piece of land that you would want to acquire. So there are so many factors that you need to consider. Of course, you have your personal preference. You have the preference as the family. Which areas would you prefer? Would you prefer low density suburbs? Would you prefer a gated community? Would you prefer high density suburbs? Those are the other issues that you need to consider as a family. Of course, gated communities have their own advantages in terms of security, in terms of privacy, in terms of the sense of communities, in terms of extra amenities that are in within the location or in within the community. So those are other factors that you also need to consider, especially when you are dealing with residential land. When it comes to commercial land, you also need to consider in terms of demand, in terms of the market, in terms of direct demand in that area, putting the catchment area, the income levels of the people who stays in that area, the demographic structures of the people who stays in that area. So the other factors that you need to consider. When it comes to industrial stand, you also need to consider transport linkages. Of course, transport linkages, they apply to either commercial, residential, and let's take an example for Semile. It's all connected to Boroto Road, which is the main road, which is used by the elite, and Harare Drive that connects the other areas like Marlborough, Avontel, like Westgate, and the GCPD side and the Greenville side. They are also connected by Harare Drive and the Boroto Road. That's why there is a high value of land in Senile in terms of connectivity. Where is it connected? So it applies to industrial. Is it connected to the rail lines? Is it connected to the road networks? Is it connected to accessibility to access that? Even if it's a farm, you also need to consider issues of accessibility and the distance from the main cities. So that was it for today for this episode. I'll see you in the next episode. Cheers.